This is Derek DeGrazia, and I am the course designer for the 2015 Duda Corporation Fairhill International. I'm going to go ahead and give you an overview of this year's three-star track and taking a look at a number of the jumps and combinations that are going to be jumped on this year's course. Starting out, the competitors will bear immediately to the right as they come out of the start box, where they will jump four straightforward galloping fences, which should help in establishing the rhythm and settling down before heading to the first combination at 5 A, B, and C, the frog pond. The jump in over a big log should be quite inviting, however from there the riders will have to maintain the bend to the duck in the middle of the water and finally to the brush at the top of the rise coming out of the water. This should not prove to be too difficult unless the horse has second thoughts about jumping into the water, otherwise it is a turning exercise that most should do easily. As they gallop down the track to fence 6A and B, the Fox Mill, the riders will have to think about having the control they need to jump in over the large oxer and then to make the correct turn, followed by having a straight horse to jump the right-handed corner off of a left-handed bend. This combination has been changed this year and the location of the oxer will make the riders think a little more about the pace and control needed to get to the corner correctly. There is an option here over another corner, however it will waste a lot of time on the clock. After a long gallop, they will only have fence 7, the Fairhill Table, which should come nicely out of the stride before galloping all the way up to the top of the hill and into the next field. The Canary Cottages 8A and B will have a slightly downhill approach, which will affect the balance as they approach the fence. Control and the correct length of stride is needed to take on this combination, which will have two narrow cottages on a related distance running down the hill. A long gallop will take them to the Sunrise Ditch and Brush number 9, which needs a bold horse, but should be a flyer for most. The keyhole at the top of the mound, fence 10A, will require a brave horse and rider, and will take them down into the water where they will need to find the line to the left-handed corner at fence 10B. The location at the of the corner at the top of the rise will make the line more difficult as they come out of the water. They will need to keep their position and maintain their direction as the corner will come up very quickly. As they come to the snake at 11, they will need to be bold, however all should just fly over this before they head up the hill to Rachel's Rails. While this has been reshaped this year, it still requires a brave horse and rider that will come on that active canter and be there to help in guiding them out. the narrow brush at the top of the mound will test their accuracy. However, if they want to play it safe, there is an alternative narrow brush that should be easier but will require more time to accomplish. Still climbing, they will have a long gallop over two fairly large galloping fences before getting to the top of the course, where they will come to 15 A and B, the turn at Persimmon Corner. A part of this fence was removed from the course last year when the footing deteriorated during the competition. However, this year it is back and the ground between the jumps has been completely redone. The right speed and line will be crucial in negotiating the turn between the two jumps. Galloping back up the hill towards the arena, they will already be contemplating what is about to come: the brush corner number 16 and then the subsequent Duda farmhouses 17 A and B. As they approach the arena, they will need to think about the right pace so as not to be coming too fast down the slope. Otherwise, it will make the approach to the brush corner that much more difficult. Once past the brush corner, it is all about the line and being on the right length stride to jump the two offset Duda farmhouses. The exit from the arena will take them towards the back of the food court over number 18, the double brush, before coming to number 19, the curving log at the soft sunken road. After jumping the double brush, the riders will have to make sure that they are not too quick going into the sunken road, so they give their horse time to assess the fallen log at the top of the slope. The long gallop to the centerpiece, 2820 AB, the oxer and angled brush, will let them have a breather. However, they want to be accurate and in control on the approach so that they guarantee a good jump, which will help in lining up one of the brushes on the way out. This is a new combination this year and will need some thought. I think you will see both sides jumped as the distances to the two brushes are a little different from each other. Galloping back up the hill, they will come to the potting shed 21, which will be a good let up before heading to the barnyard corners 22 A and B. These corners have been in various places on the course over many years and always deserve respect as they need an accurate ride and the right length of stride. At this point in the course, the horses may start to feel a little tired, which means the riders will need to be there even more to help out. The open oxer at 23 should not be a problem and will keep their confidence on the way to the last complex on the course, 24 A, B, and C, the Springhouse Water. The preparation on the approach will be important as they negotiate the large brush rail jumping down the slope into the water, followed by the chevron brush, which will come up fast and will be there to make sure they still have control and accuracy. The exit from the water will be over a boathouse at the top of the slope, which should be ridden and not taken for granted. If at this point in the course you are still jumping without fault, you want to be very careful not to have any unwanted mistakes. The gallop and ensuing three straightforward jumps will bring them to the finish.